Hello everybody and welcome. Right, so today I want to impart some essential wishing strategy advice to you all. I know I said this was for everyone, but honestly, if you are whaled up to the max, the advice is pretty simple. You know, if you just C6, R5, everything, well then you just keep wishing until you've got what you want. Simple. So that's that category of people dealt with. The other two categories are firstly free to play, and I will include in that people who buy Welcome Moon and Battle Pass, as all this really does is increase the daily amount of Prima Gems you get up from just the basic 60 from doing the daily commissions, and it doesn't really have any other effect on your wishing strategy. You've just got more to work with. The second category are those who actually spend money on Prima Gems. Now, I don't recommend doing this, by the way. I've been having an amazing amount of fun building my free-to-play account, and I haven't spent a penny on it. Obviously, because it's free to play. But if you do spend some money, what choices should you make in order to maximize your bang for buck? Firstly, let's talk about a few wishing basics. Whilst the exact chances of getting a given 4 or 5 star or a weapon are only known to Hoyoverse, there are some things we do know for sure because they've told us. You will definitely get a 5 star every 90 wishes, and there is a 50% chance that it will be the character that's on the banner you're wishing on. If your last 5 star wasn't the banner character, then the next one will be. What this means is that you should think of it as taking 180 wishes max to get the 5 star you want, though you may well get them around the halfway mark. Clearly, therefore, if you are 20 wishes past the 50-50, you are not at 20 pity and only risking 20 wishes if you continue on that banner. You're actually at 110 out of 180, and you are risking a lot by pulling, provided you don't want the 5 star, of course. By the way, the chances of getting a particular 4 star on banner are only 16% per 10 pull, so not that great. Take me for example. On my free-to-play account, which I only started about 10 days ago, I desperately wanted a copy of Cookie, who is currently on banner along with Sino and Nayato and Kirara and Zhangling. Firstly, because building a cracked Hyperbloom team is so much easier than any other kind of team archetype, and secondly, because I can use her healing to run around Dragonspine without worrying about dying from the sheer cold. Dia, by the way, will also have the same sort of free roaming ability that you get from Cookie. Makes it a lot easier for looking for things like Crimson Agates that are halfway up a mountain. Now, obviously, wishes are in short supply on an FTP account. However, I was perfectly happy with either of the other 2 4 stars, Kirara, decent shield, and Zhangling, who is busted. Both are very good and generally useful, especially Zhangling, who is doubly useful if you can get her C4. And Ayato, the 5 star, is also an extremely good general purpose hydro character, so whatever came out of the gacha, I'd be spending my wishes wisely, I thought. Also, as the account is new, there are a huge number of quests to do and chests to open, so the Prima Gem supply is much greater than it would be later in the game. And I did manage to get my cookie! Yeah. So much more useful than... come on. Oh, you see? She missed it. Unbelievable. Yeah, Lisa is not the one for Hyperbloom. Oh, for goodness sake. Another major consideration to think about is what's coming up in the next banner or two. If Nahida was to be on banner in 4.3, I would probably change things up a little bit for my free-to-play account and wouldn't have tried so hard to get Cookie, who I have got one copy of finally, hallelujah. So, Nahida is just a busted dendro applicator in the game, and she can be used in a vast majority of teams where she's usually the best in slot. So yeah, she would be a great pickup for almost any account. But she's not in the 4.3 banner, hence why I don't mind potentially getting Ayato or as many copies of Zhang Ling and Kuki and Kirara as I can get my hands on. Another way to think about it is, if the worst happens, can I make use of what I get? If the answer is no, then you probably shouldn't wish on that banner. And F2P should very rarely consider the weapon banner at all. It is a trap. On the weapon banner, you require 240 wishes to guarantee the weapon you want. Assuming you set the epitomized path to that weapon and you spend 240 wishes on just that banner. If you didn't, or you did that thing where you set the epitomized path to the wrong weapon because you thought maybe that would make Hoyo give you what you want, then you may never actually get the weapon you're after. And please note, the epitomized path does not carry over to the next weapon banner, unlike the character pity. Just to round things off for the F2P people out there, in order to help you build accounts that can easily clear whatever you aim them at, Hoyo have created Masterless Star Glitter. You should not be tempted to waste this on a few more wishes, and instead use it to get the 4-star supports that will make your chosen 5-stars really shine. Most of these original 4-stars are seriously, seriously good characters, and often compete favourably with 5-stars, while being more versatile to boot. A guaranteed Sing Sho might transform things for your favourite DPS that you've just spent 3 months worth of wishes getting, like for example Alhaitham. In fact, Sing Sho pairs with more or less everyone brilliantly. He's great with Benny and Zhang Ling as well, and yeah, he's a great pickup. You can also get some of these characters, the ones from Li Wei, during the Lantern Rite, which is hopefully coming up at the beginning of next year. So, for those that are willing to spend money on wishes, the maths is the same, but unlike FTP, you can take a chance on something that you don't necessarily want, because if the worst happens, you can always fix it with Genesis Crystals. But to play it safe, don't exceed your budget and look for those banners where whatever happens, you win. Those are the safe bets. Just a quick word on 4-stars, because you can take a few more risks, with non-free-to-play, of course. If you desperately want a copy of that particular character and you're not past the 50-50, you can perhaps, you know, put at risk up to sort of 30-odd wishes to see what comes out. Obviously, remember, it's only a 16% chance per 10 pull of a particular 4-star, so don't get your hopes up. But essentially, if all you're risking is 30 wishes, and you end up with a 5-star that you don't particularly want, well, any 5-star for 30 wishes is actually a pretty good deal. And if you win the 50-50, well, now you're actually at 90 wishes in your 180-wish journey to your chosen 5-star, so If you don't want it, don't continue. You're putting a lot at risk to go past the 50-50 trying to hunt down a 4-star. Personally, I wouldn't risk it at any rate. Better to keep the guarantee and get the 5-star you really want some point in the future. Also, another thing to bear in mind is that new characters will generally rerun much sooner than older characters. If you really want that copy of Nahida, it could be that she won't be on banner again for another 12 months after her next rerun. So that is something to consider. I would suggest that she should get a higher priority for that reason than somebody like Nouvellette or Farina, because they will almost certainly be back in the next 3 months. Now, obviously, we've had their banners now, so when they do rerun, it could be it for the next 12 months for them. So they're on the higher priority list for me now. But for example, Navia, she'll be back in another 4 months or so anyway, so you can just get her then. And this is more or less how I feel about her. I'm going to wait and see how I feel, especially as Yoimiya won't be back for 12 months, probably, and I don't have her, so she's probably the better pickup for me in the upcoming banners. On the subject of looking ahead, it really helps with planning your wishes and getting the most out of your Primo Gems. Hence, why Hoyoverse don't announce anything except the next immediate banner. You, however, should still look ahead as much as possible by paying some attention to whatever leaked information you might find out there. At the end of the day, given the number of characters and the length of time between banner reruns, most leaked stroke guessed information is around 80 to 90% accurate from what I've seen. Another thing to bear in mind is that some characters really want other characters in order to shine. Wanderer is great, for example, but he really wants Farazan. And he wants Farazan at C6. Plus, he wants a good buffer or healer, and preferably a shield with a really long duration. Clearly, his best teams are going to be quite an investment, to say the least. Though with some characters, there are also open world considerations. Wanderer makes getting around the map and reaching those hard to get to Oculus so much easier. Don't normally take a hit using this team, but I was being distracted by trying to talk. Yeah, I actually really like Wanderer, but to get the most out of him, definitely, it's high investment. I've got him at C0 here, and he's paired with 3 C6 4-stars. And they also have Favonius weapons, and he's got the 4-star Widsith weapon at R5, so yeah, it's an investment to get somewhere like this. If you can only pick up one copy of Wanderer, not his weapon, and you don't have Farazan or high constellations on the support, I'll probably still get him because, you know, he can fly! With all that said, you should do the test runs for the characters, absolutely, before you wish. That way, you can pull for only the characters that you enjoy playing and are going to get the most use out of. After all, a 5-star is an investment, and it would be a shame if you found yourself with a character that you don't enjoy and don't really use, and that cost a fortune to obtain. This advice, however, is mainly aimed at the DPS characters, people like Sino. These support characters, they're usually on field for a very short space of time, they do their skill, and then you swap out to your main DPS, and they're the ones you spend most of your time on. You might not particularly like Xing Shou, and to be honest, I didn't really like his character to begin with, but he enables so many teams that otherwise just wouldn't work very well. His abilities are particularly useful, honestly, Xing Shou, because you've got interruption resistance, you've got damage through his rain swords, you've even got a little bit of healing. He really is a master of all, quite honestly. Yep, he's a handy old character, is Xing Shou, so no question about it. So well worth trying to get a copy and build him and as many constellations as you can get your hands on. He is one of the most busted characters in the game. For example, you could pair him with Wanderer and he'd work great in that case too. When I first started playing the game, I resisted building many of the 4-stars that are in the Star Glitter shop for the longest time, as I didn't like their designs particularly, but remember, Hoyo give you a guaranteed way to get these characters for a reason. They are the backbone of the game, allowing you to build fun and powerful teams with ease and use the 5-stars of your choice. Right, so when, if ever, is the weapon banner a good idea? As I said, definitely if you're free to play, I would steer well clear. At the moment, I'm actually putting some spare wishes into the weapon banner because I'm not that interested in the next banner in particular. I already have Ayaka, she's great, but I've got her at C0 and I'm happy with that. And I'm happy to wait with Navia. And what I really like the sound of is getting the Mist Splitter that should be paired with Ayaka. That I would, yes. So I'm willing to take a chance. Now I know I've got a 1 in 3 chance. I'm approaching Pity on the weapon banner. And it's worth it. A 1 in 3 chance, I can live with that. Hopefully the 4 stars are good, we don't know yet. But if not, I'll put the rest of my wishes into probably Yoimiya in the second half of 4.3. I should be able to also make use of Navia's Claymore if I do get that, so I suppose there's a consolation prize in that. And you never know, when it comes to the 5-star standard banner weapons, you've got to try and just make use of whatever you get. At least it'll be a reasonable stat stick in most cases. See, it's about managing risk with these things and not taking ridiculous chances on long shots, which would leave you terribly disappointed if you lose. Oh, and obviously, as I said before, spend what you can afford, of course, or spend nothing at all. At the end of the day, it's a form of gambling and the game is 99% as fun, even if you don't spend anything, or at least just maybe Welkin Moon and the Battle Pass. I mean, at the end of the day, Welkin and the Battle Pass are pretty manageable amounts per month. It works out to more or less the same as a Netflix subscription, so it's not bank-breaking. Or you could just spend nothing at all, and the game would still be 90% as great. Okay, that brings me to the end of my tips and tricks and strategies to do with wishing. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you did, please smash the like button and subscribe if you haven't already, because it really helps the channel out, and I'd love to see you here again in the future. Good luck, and may you win all your 50-50s.